بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد. Dear respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another brand new episode of the program entitled Towards the Origin, broadcasted live from the studio of Channel S, watched on Sky 777. To all of those who have just joined with us, also through our social media platform, that is Facebook page, or via our website, thank you very much for joining in, and inshallah this program will go for an hour, and following day, in the morning at 11 o'clock, you'll watch the repeat of the show, and later on you'll also find us on our YouTube channel. Our tonight's discussion is on the topic, Our Children, Our Legacy. Now, how many of us as parents do we understand the importance of children in our life, especially to those who have been blessed with this ni'mah? Ask those, perhaps, who do not have children, perhaps we may find a different perspective to it. Do we really understand the good upbringing, nurturing, giving them the right tarbiyah for them to prepare in their future world? When I say prepare, that does not necessarily mean to be successful in this world, but also how to be successful in the hereafter, the eternal life. All of this and many more, inshallah, we'll discuss. And most importantly, our children are ambassadors and they will be carrying our legacy. What legacy do we want to leave behind? What knowledge do we want to leave behind? What sort of children do we want to leave behind? Those that remember us when we have left the world, or those that have forgotten when we leave the world? What type of children? How do we nurture? All of this and many more, inshallah, we'll discuss in our tonight's episode. And to discuss this topic, we have been joined by our regular guest, who is the respected Imaam and Khateeb of London Central Mosque and Islamic Cultural Centre, famously known as Regent's Park Mosque, Fadilat al-Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
First of all, thank you very much for joining with us once again so late at night.
My pleasure. Jazakallah khairan.
Now, let's start. The topic is Our Children, Our Legacy. Now, let's start with the word or the term legacy first, and then we'll come to the children and the root of it. Now, what do we understand by the term legacy?
طيب الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد. After praising Allah and sending salam and salutations to the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and he has no partners. And I also testify that the noble messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger and slave of Allah, the Almighty. Before we go to the word legacy, I would like to make a dua for the brothers and sisters who will be going to Hajj, inshallah, very soon. And we're in the month of Dhul Qa'dah, soon we'll be in the month of Dhul Hijjah. And I know lots of and many, many brothers and sisters from across the world, and especially from UK, United Kingdom, are going to the Baytullah, the sacred land of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in Mecca al-Mukarrama and Medina al-Munawwara. I make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that may Allah accept your efforts, may Allah the Almighty grant you the ni'mah of sincerity, and may He bring you, all of you, back to us safely, and also may He give us the tawfiq, the ability to also travel and make and perform the Hajj again and again, repeatedly around the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the noble Quran, وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ. He ordered the noble messenger Ibrahim alayhi wa ala nabiyyina salam, لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ, to build and to construct the house of Allah. مَكَان أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا, so that this house becomes free of shirk. This house becomes free from the associating partnership with Allah. وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا وَطَهِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ, and to purify the house of Allah. Allah pak rabbul alamin er gorke pobitro korar jonno. وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا وَطَهِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْقَائِمِينَ وَالرُّكَّعِ السُّجُودِ, and so those who will come and go around and those who will spend, they will, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He makes pure, makes the house clean and pure for those pilgrims, the hujjaj, jara bishir anache kanache theke Allah pak rabbul alaminer ei pobitro bhumi pobitro land er moddhe jokhon ashben ebong tara tawaf korben tara sa'i korben tara Allah pak rabbul alaminer gorer ashepashe tara jaben tawaf korben, ওই গোটে আল্লাহ পাক রহমান পবিত্র এবং শিরিক থেকে মুক্ত করে রেখেছেন, অর্থাৎ আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলমিনের আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলমিনের সাথে আর কোনো মাবুদকে শরিক না করে শুধু আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলম ইবাদতের জন্যই এই ঘরকে নির্মাণ করেছেন।
Now you've picked a very important point there because you've touched on it. That's why I just wanted to make sure I add that point in because some of our viewers may have some questions regarding this aspect when you said there's no shirk. But when we see there the Maqam Ibrahim, the way it's been touched, the way the cloth have been wiped, where the Kaaba, the way it's been revered, some may wonder that that may lead into the direction of shirk. Now, how do we...
Well, I mean, of course, like, there are shirk, there are different types of shirk, major shirk and minor shirk. Major shirks are like, for example, when somebody worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, somebody worship things and objects and beings other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. Minor shirk, like, you know, the people can, for example, when people do riya, showing off, praying or doing things for beings other than Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, they can be considered a minor shirk. But to touch upon the houses of Allah with the intention of getting some blessings, I don't think they become shirk, but it is obviously like we have to keep our intention correct. Some people do for the blessing, but of course, like, you know, this can cause a lot of harm and inconvenience for other people while doing this.
For example, when we go to Madinat al-Munawwar, a lot of people, instead of making dua outside towards the direction of Qibla, they make the direction of that dome, the green dome.
Duas should be, it's sunnah to make the dua towards the Qibla, but if someone makes dua to any direction, but with the condition that he's not seeking dua from things other than Allah, then that's okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wherever you turn your direction, you find Allah. So we can make dua to any direction, that's not a problem.
But the problem can come,
yes, intention, yes.
Because we can't be seeking help from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
We cannot ask help from, of course we can't help directly from anybody apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But of course, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he does intercession, he does shafa'ah for us. And so we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to grant us the shafa'ah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who obviously will become a means of help and intercession on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Now, coming back to our very important topic tonight, and that is our children, our legacy. What do we understand from the word legacy? Legacy is what we leave behind after we depart this world. Amra ei prithibi theke amra jokhon amra chole jai amra ki rekhe jabo amra kon jinish gulo amra rekhe jabo ei jinish gulo amra ba amader je uttor shuri ba amader jara bangla je mirash bola hoy mirash but ba arabite amra mirath bole thaki inheritance amra ki rekhe jabo legacy. So we are talking tonight, our children, our legacy. অর্থাৎ আমাদের সবথেকে বড় যে legacy, আমাদের সবথেকে বড় যে উত্তরসূরি, আমাদেরকে যারা represent করবে, those who will represent us after our departure, those will act on our behalf, those who will be reflection of us, they are our children, they are our awlad, আমাদের সন্তান সন্ততি, আমাদের ছেলেমেয়ে, আমাদের legacy, আমাদের উত্তরসূরি. And so how can we take this matter seriously? This is what we'll be discussing.
Generally, when you say the word miras, inheritance, shathe shathe shampoder kotha matai chole.
Exactly. Of course, that's true. And many of us, we think what we leave behind is just the wealth,
assets,
money,
business,
or properties,
houses,
or which is fine to make money in this world because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He allows us to do that. But of course, with a balance, without connecting or attaching our hearts with the dunya. Like one of the scholars, he gave a very nice example of living in this dunya, in this world. So he said, like, living in this world is just like someone who is riding a boat. So you need the water to ride the boat. You need the water. However, if the water comes into the boat, then the boat will sink. মানে নৌকার জন্য কিন্তু পানির প্রয়োজন, কিন্তু পানিটা যদি নৌকার ভিতরে চলে আসে তখন কিন্তু বিপজ্জনক হয়ে যাবে। এই জন্য নৌকার জন্য পানি প্রয়োজন, কিন্তু পানিটা কিন্তু ভিতরে আসতে পারবে না। ঠিক তদ্রূপ আমরা পৃথিবীর মধ্যে এই দুনিয়ার মধ্যে আমরা থাকতে হবে, কিন্তু দুনিয়াটা যদি আমাদের কালবের ভিতরে, আমাদের হার্টের ভিতরে, হৃদয়ের ভিতরে চলে আসে তখন কিন্তু এটাই সমস্যা, বিপজ্জনক হয়ে যাবে। সো অ্যাগেইন, মেকিং মানি in a halal way, it's fine, and it's of course needed, and it's a very important. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said in a hadith, "Ad-dunya mazra'atun lil akhirah." This world is the cultivation for the next world. So we do things in this world correctly within the parameters, within the boundaries of Islam. But again, of course, like with the correct intention and by giving the rights of the wealth. But as you said very rightly, that many of us, when we talk about inheritance, mirath, we think about we think about the properties, we think about the worldly assets, right? But unfortunately, those assets will not benefit unless they are done in a charitable way or in a correct way. I know of somebody, a lady who became billionaire within just 2 weeks' time. You might think, oh, how did that happen? So she got married to a husband, and I think that happened in USA. And the husband died after, he was a billionaire, and husband died after a while, after a few days, and the lady became inherited the wealth. Mm. So you can imagine how much hard work the man he did in order to make and gather those wealth. But then somebody. So this is how actually what we leave behind instantly, someone else become the owner of those wealth and assets and properties and gold and silver that we leave behind. But what is beneficial and what is important are the things that we leave behind, but they will represent us. There will be a beneficial things even after we leave this world. So let me just talk a little bit about the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty bestowed incredible amount of blessings in our life. উনি আমাদেরকে অসংখ্য অগণিত নিয়ামত দ্বারা ভরপুর করে রেখেছেন। আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন আমাদেরকে অনেক নিয়ামত দিয়েছেন, জীবনের নিয়ামত। আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন আমাদেরকে সুন্দর জীবন দিয়েছেন, বাসা বাড়ি দিয়েছেন, আমাদেরকে গাড়ি গুলো দিয়েছেন। আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন হি গেভ আস হাজবেন্ডস, মানে অনেকদেরকে হাজবেন্ড দিয়েছেন। অনেক মহিলা আছেন এই বিশ্বের মধ্যে, তারা হাজবেন্ড পাচ্ছেন না। ফর হাজবেন্ডস আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু তাআলা ব্লেসড উইথ ওয়াইভস। সো মেনি পিপল দে হ্যাভ ওয়াইভস, দে ওয়ান্ট টু গেট ম্যারিড বাট দে কান্ট ফাইন্ড right and correct spouses. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them the ni'mah of spouse, ni'mah of children, and he gives, he says in the noble Quran, the word gifts, he gives the gifts to people when he talks about the children. So he says, yahabu liman yasha'u inatha, whomsoever he wishes, he grant them the girls. Daughters. And whomsoever he wishes, he gives them the boys. So why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned girls first and why boys after? Because you know, in the time of Jahiliyyah, people used to feel embarrassed having the daughters. And that's still there in many parts of the world. Yeah. And this is the reason why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he bring the girls first. He says, yahabu liman yasha'u inatha. And then he says, wadhukur, wahyabu liman yasha'u dhukur. And then he said, "أو يزوجهم ذكرانا وإناثا." And whomsoever he wishes, he give them both, girls, daughters, and sons. ويجعل من يشاء عقيما. And whomsoever he wishes, he keeps them without children. So this is not a right of human being over Allah. It's his own choice and his own, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the children as a gift and not our rights. It's amader kono odhikar noy, amader kono praipo noy. Allah pak jodi diye taken, alhamdulillah, rabbil alamin. Ar jodi na diye taken, tahole amaderke sabar korte hobe, dhorjo korte hobe. Allah pak rabbil alaminer siddhanter upor amra khushi ebong shanti thakte hobe.
Very true, but some people may say, ajkal to science to onek advance hoye geche. What would you say to that?
Meaning?
In terms of people who are having difficulties in having, especially if a female is finding it difficult to conceive a child, mm-hmm. they might say the medical science is advanced and a lot of help can be taken through medical
science.
That
is fine. I mean, as long as it's in a rightful way and halal way, that's fine. But we need to understand that originally, again, those won't work. Unless Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala, he made the decree.
That means they
so
have
none
to
of these
be,
things will
the will
work.
Of Allah has to be first.
Definitely,
then,
definitely. Okay. Some, obviously, Allah gives them directly without any difficulties, but others have to work hard or maybe go through in a different way.
And you've said a very correct thing through correct procedure. And
exactly,
correct,
yes,
okay.
Yes. In a rightful way
rightful
we have to
way.
Go through. Otherwise, of course, we have to be patient. And as I said, these are ni'am and Allah's blessings, and nobody have any, nobody can make a complaint.
Now, to see, when you say it's a blessing, then how come, especially, I'm just talking about from a community community perspective that we live in, how come then we neglect our very own children and get busy with association, organization for nothing, perhaps?
Yeah, that's right.
Now, where is the right? Where is the balance?
Yes, that is really, really true what you said. We'll come to that, you know, when we talk about our responsibilities and roles towards our children.
And definitely, I'm not saying everyone.
No, of course.
But there are some challenges.
Sure, definitely. আমরা যখন আমাদের দায়িত্ব কি আছে আমাদের ছেলেমেয়েদের প্রতি, ইনশাআল্লাহ ওই সময় আলোচনা করব. So now, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala granted us different types of ni'mah, but we're so close to those ni'am and bounties, so therefore we don't understand. আমরা মানে খুবই নিকটবর্তী, এজন্য আমরা বুঝতে পারি না যে আমাদের কাছে কতটুকু আল্লাহপাক দিয়েছেন. Okay, now, part of those blessings, one of the greatest blessings of Allah, according to the Quranic verse, are the children or the ni'mah of children. And so therefore Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, in this temporary world, in this very, very temporary, konostai jibonen moddhe Allah pakra balam kichu shundorjo diyechen. Er moddhe ekta hocche je ad-dunya mata' wa khayru mata'iha zawjatun salihah, je ei dunya anandomoy ebong sundor ekta jaga, ebong ei jagar moddhe aro ekta shundorjo hocche je ekjon bhalo stri, a righteous wife, obviously for wife is a righteous husband. This is the beauty of this world. But also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says in the noble Quran, ba'd a'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim, his al-malu والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا. The mal, the wealth, والبنون, the children are the beauty of this world. المال والبنون زينة. What is زينة? زينة means beauty, adornment. A পৃথিবীর সৌন্দর্যের মধ্যে এই জীবনের কোনস্থায়ী জীবনের সৌন্দর্যের মধ্যে হচ্ছে যে মাল আমাদের সন্তান সন্ততি এবং আমাদের যে সম্পদ এইগুলো অক্ষণস্থায়ী জীবনের সৌন্দর্য তবে আল্লাহ পাক বলে আমি বলতে চাচ্ছেন আমাদেরকে ওয়াল বাকিয়াতুস সালিহাত যেটা থেকে যাবে হোয়াট উইল রিমেইন আস সালিহাতু খায়রুন ইনদা রাব্বিকা সাওয়াবা দ্য গুড ডিডস ভালো কাজ গুড কাজ যে আমল সালেহ এইগুলো কিন্তু আমাদের জন্য থেকে যাবে ওয়াল বাকিয়াতুস সালিহাতু খায়রুন ইনদা রাব্বিকা সাওয়াবা ওয়া খায়রুন আমালা ওইটাই আমাদের জন্য সোর্স অফ রিওয়ার্ড হয়ে থাকবে যে ভালো কাজ আপনি আজকে একজনকে সাহায্য করেছেন ইউ হেল্প সামবডি ইউ সার্ভড ইউর প্যারেন্টস ইউ সার্ভড ইউর চিলড্রেন ইউ ফেড ইউর চিলড্রেন ইউ লুকড আফটার ইউ টুক কেয়ার অফ ইউর হাজব্যান্ড ইউ টুক কেয়ার অফ ইউর ওয়াইফ ইউ টুক কেয়ার অফ ইউর নেইবার্স ইউ টুক কেয়ার অফ দি ফেলো হিউম্যান বিং সোসাইটি What you do is a charity, you built a masjid, you built a madrasa, you built a school, you built a center of education. You may be like, you did something that is charitable and beneficial, a work or action of welfare. Those will remain. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتِ Now, Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala is telling us the children and the wealth are the beauty and adornment of the world. Now, we need to understand, those beauty can turn into niqma. Ni'mah can go into ni'mah is blessing, and niqma is something that like something like a test. So those
trial.
Ni'mah, trial, can turn into niqma, or they can turn into porikkar karon hoye darate pare. Ei je ni'amat gulor jodi amra bhalo bhabe eta shot bebohar na kori
এখানে আরেকটা জিনিস ক্লারিফাই করা দরকার when you say the term ni'mah does it not need to associate with iman because the ni'mah can only be understood if the person has iman in the first place where if the iman does not exist then how can that be a ni'mah then in the first place
exactly so well there are different types of bounties and the I mean for us as Muslim we say the greatest bounty is the bounty of iman
We have been discussing, my dear viewers, the topic for tonight's Our Children, Our Legacy and the importance of children and the importance of bounty and blessing that has been explained by our Sheikh. It's no doubt people who have it, people who possess those bounties and blessings, perhaps we might be sometime negligent. Inshallah, when we come after the break, we'll be discussing more into details and find out a little bit of our role and responsibility as parents towards our children and what sort of legacy do we need to leave behind? Do stay tuned with us. We'll be right back in a few moments. Wassalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back from break. You're watching Towards the Origin in conversation with Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman, who is one of the respected Imam and Khateeb of London Central Mosque and Islamic Cultural Center. Our tonight's topic is on our children, our legacy.
You're watching this program live on Channel S, Sky 777, and also to those who have joined us through our social media platform and via our website. Thank you very much. And you'll be finding the repeat of this program on the following day, which is 11 o'clock in the morning. And later on, also, you'll find us on our YouTube channel. Now, Sheikh, let's continue our discussion on this topic. But before we go into a little bit more detail, I just wanted to pick on some aspect from our first segment, just to summarize for people who might have missed the first segment. Now, when we say a legacy, we've touched upon certain time or the common word that we understand about legacies, inheritance that is associated with the wealth, and you've clarified the understanding that it doesn't necessarily have to mean inheritance.
Legacy is something where you leave behind and people
others to benefit and prosper.
And like your deeds.
Correct.
That remain behind.
Now, I just wanted to touch on the flip side of it. এখন আমি সন্তান রেখে গেছি যাকে কোরআন হাদিস ভালোভাবে শিক্ষা দেই নাই, গান নাচ সব দিকে এমন ভাবে মানে আকৃষ্ট হয়েছে যে আল্লাহর কালাম বা কোরআন বা ইসলামের সাথে সম্পর্ক নাই.
Yes,
what
I mean,
happens to that?
I mean, for as Muslims, we would say that, you know, something that's benefit us in this world and in the next world is what something that we know we call legacy. Okay. But maybe to others, like, you know, it could be something else as a legacy. But from the Islamic perspective, we say something that will benefit us in the next world. That's what we are, because we as Muslims, we are, our vision and our understanding of the world is way different to many people in this world.
So in short, you're trying to say people who are the follower of Islamic faith must adhere to the Islamic core principles and primary focus should not only be the dunya, but the akhirah. Is that what you're trying
exactly
to say?
Exactly, connected. Okay. Because we think beyond this world. A lot of people are the people of the dunya, they just think about dunya. But we as Muslims, we think beyond this world, the dunya. And this is the reason why Muslims have a much more higher and a longer and deeper vision. And that's obviously to build the next world. Now, coming back to the discussion, of course, like we said, the children are the biggest ni'mah, but they can turn into a form of fitna and test and tribulation. Amader jonno porikkar karon, amader jonno test among tribulation er karon hoye darate pare. Acha kibhabe ajke dekhen apne amader onek পিতামাতারা অনুশোচনা করছেন, আমাদের অনেক পিতামাতারা কিন্তু রিগ্রেট করতেছেন যে ছেলেমেয়েরা কথা শুনে না. দিস ইজ ভেরি কমন ওয়ান, চিলড্রেন ডোন্ট লিসেন টু আস. আচ্ছা, তারপরে বলা যায় যে ছেলেমেয়েরা কিন্তু আপনার রং রিলেশনশিপে ঢুকে যাচ্ছে, মানে ভিন্ন ভিন্ন সম্পর্কের মধ্যে তারা ঢুকে যাচ্ছে. ছেলেমেয়েরা ড্রাগের মধ্যে আসক্ত হয়ে যাচ্ছে, দে গেটিং ইট ড্রাগস, দে গেটিং অ্যাডিক্টেড, ইউ নো, উইথ ইউ নো বাই ড্রাগস অ্যান্ড অবভিয়াসলি লাইক আদার.
এন্ড নাও উইভ গট নাইট ক্রাইম.
And knife crimes, of course, that's what I need to mention as well. So our children are getting into things that we cannot return, we cannot bring them back. And you see, I was reading one of the scholar's statement. He said the common thing and common mistake the parents do and make, they say, oh, the children are too young. আমাদের পিতামাতার মধ্যে একটা একটা টেন্ডেন্সি আছে, প্রবণতা আছে যে সবসময় ওনারা বলতে থাকেন যে ছেলেমেয়েরা এখনো ছোট রয়ে গেছে, স্টিল স্মল. এবং এইটাই কিন্তু আমরা উই আর গেটিং ফেইল দিস ওয়ে.
নাও লেট মি টাচ অন দ্যাট দেন. বাচ্চা আমার ছোট, ইটস টু ইয়াং. When is it mentioned? When it comes to the aspect of salah, siyam, shab kitu. Kintu jahan bachar professional bishoy ache, career bishoy ache, jahan bachar sports bishoy ache, tahan tu nara bolena je bachar choto.
Exactly, and you're right. So the tarbiyah need to start from the very beginning, from the earliest. And even, you know, like the modern medical departments confirm that the children are actually influenced by the things outside, even when they're in their mother's womb. মানে ওদের মা বাবা মায়ের গর্বের মধ্যে থাকা অবস্থায় ছেলেমেয়েরা কিন্তু অনেক জিনিস তারা আজ করতে পারে এবং অনেক জিনিস তারা প্রভাবিত হয় বাইরের জগৎ থেকে. সো ইট ইজ সারপ্রাইজিং. সো চিলড্রেন দে নেভার ইয়াং. আই মিন দিস ইজ দ্য রিজন ওয়াই সি কান্ট্রিজ লাইক দিস. এই দেশগুলোর মধ্যে আপনারা দেখতে পাবেন যে দুই বছর, আড়াই বছর, তিন বছর থেকে ছেলে মেয়েদেরকে, বাচ্চা কাচ্চাদেরকে তারা কিন্তু সিরিয়াসলি পড়াশোনার দিকে তারা নিয়ে যেতে চায়, কারণ তারা জানে যে ওরা কিন্তু ভেরি আর্লি এজ থেকে আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড করতে পারে, অনেক জিনিস বুঝতে পারে.
এন্ড নট অনলি দ্যাট, দ্য কান্ট্রি নোজ এটা হচ্ছে ভবিষ্যৎ, কিন্তু দেশের জন্য অ্যাসেট.
এক্স্যাক্টলি. এন্ড আওয়ার পিপল, আমরা যে আমাদের যে মানে কমন কথা হচ্ছে, ওরা কি বুঝবে? মানে বাচ্চা কাচ্চাদেরকে আমরা যখন তারা 7 বছর 8 বছর 10 বছর হয়ে গেছে তো আমাদের কাছে কোনো একটা জিনিস নিয়ে আসছে আমাদেরকে আমাদের মতামত নিয়ে আসছে বা একটা প্রশ্ন নিয়ে আসছে তখন আমরা কমন যে আমরা কথাটা বলি যে ও কি বুঝবে ওয়াইজ গোনা আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড ওয়াইজ শি গোনা আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড
এন্ড দি আদার সাইড অফ ইট এখানে আরেকটি প্রবলেম হচ্ছে আমরা যখন বলি আল্লাহ গুনাহ দেবে আল্লাহ মারবে একটা বাচ্চার আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং আমরা হাউ আর উই প্রেজেন্টিং দ্যাট টু দ্য চাইল্ড
সি আই মিন সো দিস ইজ ডিসিপ্লিনারি প্রসিজার নাও সাম অফ আস মে বি উই গেভ এ রং ইমেজ অফ ইসলাম by just saying that everything is all about hell and heaven. I mean, of course, we can talk about heaven, but we speak a lot about hell, like, dujoke chole jabe, jahanname chole jabe, eta korle jahanname
chole jabe. And we say the word Allah marbe. Where did that come from?
Ejono amader priyo nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ota kintu jahannamer byapare ebong egula kintu Quran-er moddhe alochona hoyeche, hadith-er moddhe eta bolte hobe shomoy shomoy. We have to, of course, remind ourselves time to time.
But at what time? What stage?
Not all the time. তবে আমাদেরকে ভালো খবর দিতে হবে প্রথমে এর জন্য রসুল করিম সাহাসাম উনি বলেছেন সাহাবায়ে কারামদেরকে যখন অন্য অন্য জায়গার মধ্যে ওনারা ছড়িয়ে ছিটিয়ে পড়তেন তখন উনি বলেছেন যে বাশিরু গুড নিউজ প্রথমে গুড নিউজ দিও ও মানুষদেরকে জাতিদেরকে প্রথমে তোমরা গুড নিউজ দাও বাশির ওয়ালা তুনাফিরু yassiru wa la tu'assiru make things easy and don't make things difficult for people so when we obviously talk to our children we don't as you rightly mentioned that we don't always say those things but rather we say things that are encouraging motivation utshamulok amra kotha bolte pari je amader ke ejonno our scholars actually those the scholars who are the scholars of spirituality the big scholars of Islam they always said that love for Allah need to be built before anything else.
That's the foundation.
Foundation. And if you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I mean, look, if you love someone, you are ready to do anything for that person. Right or wrong?
That's true.
But if you are forced and if the fear is created in you for that person, you may be doing it, but not with the full love. মানে পরিপূর্ণ ভালোবাসার মাধ্যমে নয় এর জন্য আমাদের স্কলার আমাদের উলামায়ে কেরাম এবং বিশেষ করে যারা স্পিরিচুয়ালিটি রুহানি জগতের যারা উলামায়ে কেরামরা ছিলেন ওনারা সবসময় বলতেন যে ইমাম আল গাজালী রাহমাহুল্লাহ এবং যারা রুহানি জগতের ইমাম হাসান আল বসরি ওনারা বলছেন যে প্রথমত আমরা আমাদের মধ্যে ভালোবাসা আল্লাহর জন্য ভালোবাসা সৃষ্টি করতে হবে হুব লিল্লাহি সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা আল্লাহর জন্য আমরা লাভ ক্রিয়েট সৃষ্টি করতে হবে এন্ড ওয়েন উই লাভ আল্লাহ উই উইল বি হ্যাপি টু ডু এনিথিং ফর আল্লাহ and sacrifice anything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the same time, we still need to remind ourselves about, you know, of course, all of these things, the punishment that Allah mentioned. But it's not all about just punishment.
Now, see, there is a very fundamental aspect here. When we are introducing Islam to our children, how are we introducing? The first thing we talk about is punishment, hell.
That's right.
So, প্রথমেই তার negative impact.
Yes,
yes. On the other hand, যখন secular education এর দিকে যাচ্ছে, aspiration
career,
hope,
positivity,
hope,
yeah that's
future,
right.
Prospect,
you are right.
Kintu Islam eta it's all about negative.
So what happened here is like what has been said is part of it, but it's not all of it. So when we speak and do the tarbiyah and when we obviously like do da'wah, we have to do da'wah correctly, and we need to give good news to people first, the positive news first.
So basically, in other words,
don't make people put off from Islam.
In other words, you're telling or you're suggesting the training should be wholesome,
yes,
not partially or one-ended or one extreme.
Exactly,
it should be wholesome,
yes,
balanced,
yes,
approach.
Yes.
And also, there's another element we need to also mention. Not every child mature at the same age.
Yes, that you are right. And this is the reason why it is very important to understand child psychology.
Absolutely.
Sometimes what we do is another mistake we make. Just because the next door neighbor children are like this, we want our children exactly to be like that, or even, but not everybody, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala didn't give everyone same ability and same skill. Shobai kintu same talent then nai.
Now look into that. Omuker chele doctor hoyeche amar chele keno hobe na, omuker chele lawyer hoyeche tumi keno hote parba na, ei je ekta
yes
enforcement.
You're right, we can encourage in a different way, but to mention again and compare shob shomoy je tuluna kora eta kintu wrong jeta bishoy je amra ei তোমার ওই অমুক কীভাবে হয়ে গেছে, অমুক ছেলে কীভাবে হয়েছে, অমুক মেয়ে কীভাবে হয়ে গেছে, নেক্সট ইয়ার কী হয়েছে, তোমার চাচাতো ভাই মামাতো ভাই কীভাবে হয়ে গেছে, এইটা কিন্তু বারে বারে বললে কিন্তু ছেলেমেয়েরা কিন্তু তাদের কনফিডেন্সটা হারিয়ে
ফেলে, ইগো, সেলফ এস্টিম, সেলফ রেসপেক্টটাকে কিন্তু আহত করা
হয়ে যায়। এজন্য উই শুডন্ট সে টু মাচ, বাট টাইম টু টাইম উই ক্যান এনকারেজ ইনডাইরেক্টলি
ইন এ নাইস ওয়ে,
এন্ড উই হ্যাভ টু সি হাউ দ্য চিলড্রেন আর ফিলিং অ্যাজ ওয়েল, রাইট? সো Now, so talking about the children, our legacy, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said everything will be disconnected when we leave this world, apart from three things which will remain connected. Number one, he said that a sadaqah jariyah, a charitable act that you do in this world, a charity that you make sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mentioned madrasa, masjid, house, to helping people, and even building schools and educational centers are also part of the charity if we do for Allah and with the intention to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and hospitals and all of those things. And then he said, a knowledge that you left behind and people will benefit, a book, a dars, a lecture,
education, or anything,
something that you left behind and people will benefit, you get reward. Percentage of reward will go to your account. And the last thing he said, waladun salih yad'u lahu, a pious child who will make dua after we leave. Now, we need to really think as parents, like, are we leaving children who will know how to pray? Are we leaving children who will make fast? Are we leaving children who will do hajj? And most importantly, are we leaving children behind us, those who will know even make how to make dua for us, like Rabbirhamhuma, kama rabbayana sighara? Because everything, as Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying, will be disconnected and those things will only remain. So walad salih, remember, legacy, our inheritor, true inheritance, and true uttorshuri, amader jonno shottikar uttorshuri hocche amader chelemera. They will represent you. They will be an ambassador for you. If they do good things, they'll say, mashallah, children of those parents. If they do bad things, they'll say, children of those parents as well, even though sometimes we do our part.
Okay, now the other flip side, I just wanted to bring it to the attention of our viewers as well. You have told us that eigula jinish rekhe gele, they will be benefited. Now, the flip side of it, এমন কাজ রেখে গেছি যেখান থেকে মানুষ কিন্তু জাহান্নামের পথে চলে যাচ্ছে, যেখানে যেখান থেকে মানুষের ক্যারেক্টার আখলাক কিন্তু ভালোর জায়গায় কিন্তু মন্দ হচ্ছে,
রাইট?
এই সময়ে যারা এরকম লেগেসি রেখে যায়,
জি, সো এগেইন উই নিড টু থিংক অ্যাবাউট দ্যাট ভেরি ভেরি প্রোফাউন্ডলি, ইফ ইউ আর মুসলিম, if we believe in Allah, if we believe in our messenger, if we believe in the Quran and the prophetic narrations and this authentic and genuine religion, then we need to really think what will happen on the opposite, like in
just to give you things an example,
you are right.
If we leave business behind that has got haram involved in it,
or maybe anything that will promote the prohibited
things, or
harmful things,
or directly in contradiction with the Quran and Sunnah.
মানুষের ক্ষতিকর জিনিস আপনি রেখে গেছেন দুনিয়ার মধ্যে, পৃথিবীর মধ্যে, ওটার জন্য আপনি গুণা পাবেন, কিন্তু ইউ নট গোনা গেট রিওয়ার্ড, বাট ইউ উইল গেট সিন ফর দ্যাট.
এন্ড এগুলা দেখে বা করে যারা নষ্ট পথে
যাচ্ছে, ইউ উইল বি পার্ট অফ ইট, সো উই হ্যাভ টু বি মেলা প্রোটেক্ট আস, মেলা প্রোটেক্ট আস, ইয়েস.
আই মিন,
সো নাও নাও আফটার সেইং দিস, নাও অ্যাজ প্যারেন্টস, হোয়াট ক্যান উই ডু ফর আওয়ার চিলড্রেন? অফ কোর্স উই সে দ্যাট আওয়ার চিলড্রেন ডোন্ট লিসেন টু আস, and they don't obey us, they're not obedience. And that's important, we need to discuss, and we need to speak with our children another day, inshallah, perhaps during the holiday, we can speak, you know, with our children. But today we're talking to our parents, and I'm saying the first thing we need to do, that we need to create a loving relationship with our children. So as we spoke earlier, it's not just about do's and don'ts. It's not just about do this, don't do this, don't do this, do this, don't do this. Haram, halal, haram, not like this, right? We have to do in a loving way, mutual understanding.
Compassionate way.
And we need to explain things as well, time to time, rather than just shouting, hey, ita corona, ita corona, ita. Without just doing that, we need to explain things as well. I know sometimes they become also necessary.
No, that's understandable. But the arekta jinish jeta main major problem hocche, right time e bachchaderke ma babara amra shomoy dei nei kore bole,
yes,
later in the life
we regret. And this time is very important, because children remember everything that they do during this period, like early stage, because after they become jokhon ora boro hoye jabe tokhon kintu amar pitamater sathe ora kintu thakte chay na. Just avoid, stay away.
Especially the current climate, the atmosphere, and the country we live in.
Dure thake. Kintu apnara jokhon mane bachcha chara chuto thake, tokhoni kintu amaderke amader somporko, amader je sahbat, amader je companionship ta create korte hobe.
And the philosophy of life is so bizarre that when the child needs the attention, the parents are busy. And when the parents need the attention,
child
has left them.
Left them, yes. And it's too late. So حب الأولاد, I would like to say, Prophet Muhammad SAW, he taught. There was a man by the name of Al-Aqra ibn Habis. He was sitting by Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he started to kiss Hassan ibn Ali, radiallahu anhu, his grandson. When he তখন ওই আকরা ইবনে হাবিস উনি একজন বেদুইন ছিলেন, উনি একজন মরুভূমির লোক ছিলেন, বেদুইন ডেজার্ট আরব, এন্ড আমাদের অনেকের মধ্যে এটা একটা ধারণা আছে যে আপনি যদি আমাদের মানে বিশেষ করে আমাদের যে যারা গ্রামাঞ্চলে বসবাস করেন এবং যারা মরুভূমিতে বসবাস করেন এবং অনেক আছেন এই পৃথিবীর মধ্যে যে টু দ্য সাইন অফ ম্যানলি বিং লাইক মেনলি ইজ ইউ হ্যাভ টু বি হার্শ এন্ড ইউ হ্যাভ টু বি ইউ ক্যান হ্যাভ কম্প্যাশন ইউ ক্যান হ্যাভ কাইন্ডনেস মানে মার্সি থাকতে পারবে না আপনার কাছে আপনার কাছে কোনো ধরনের মায়ামহব্বত থাকবে না এই আপনি ম্যান ইউ আর ম্যান ইন দ্যাট ওয়ে Professor, this mentality carried by many people. Akra ibn Habis Bolchen, how can you kiss Hassan ibn Ali? I have 10 children. I have not kissed one of them. He's saying to Professor Azam.
Wow.
Then Professor Azam saying, "Man la yarham la yurham." Those who don't show mercy to others, Allah will not show mercy to him. Jara mane onnoder proti maya sneha momota kore na Allah pak oder proti sneha momota korben na Allah pak oder proti merciful hoben na oder proti rahmat barshan korben na Allah pak because you're not merciful to people, you're not merciful to the creation, then Allah won't be merciful to you. And this is a condition. Irhamu man fil ardi yarhamukum man fis sama. Be kind and merciful to the one on this earth, and the one in the heaven will be merciful to you, according to hadith of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi
Wasallam. Now, we don't want to be kind because that individual may have hurt me. That individual may have incurred loss at me.
Well, that's again, we have to look at the issue of afu and safh, like you know, forgiving others.
Balanced approach, you would like to say.
After this, I would say, loving relationship, we have to give them the correct teaching of Islam and religion, especially aqidah, the basic belief, the basic fiqh, basic rules and regulations of Islam, the rules of fasting, rules of salah, rules of hajj, the ibadat and worship, and the etiquettes and mannerism. Now, our predecessors, আমাদের যারা পূর্বপুরুষরা ছিলেন, ওরা কিন্তু প্রত্যেকটা সায়েন্সের মধ্যে তারা মাস্টার করেছেন. মানে ওরা, they were the masters of all science, many of them. Like people like Ibn Rushd, Ibn Sina, Khawarizmi, Ghazali, and many. Like they were actually master of all different sciences in this world. But they began always with Quran. And this is how even up until today in Al-Azhar University, in every faculty, engineering, science, business, they begin with the Quran al-Karim. I mean, every child, every student has to be a hafiz of the Quran, even though they're doing business, even though they're studying dentistry and chemistry and all of those things. So Quran and Islam was the beginning. Then they went to different routes. Because this is the main thing, this is the fundamental.
The creating a solid foundation.
And okay. After that, we can go anywhere and learn, of course, like beneficial knowledge, not the knowledge that doesn't benefit. And Prophet ﷺ, he seek refuge, said, "Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you to protect us from the knowledge that doesn't benefit."
Now here
today, our people are busy seeking the knowledge that doesn't benefit.
What does that mean, knowledge doesn't benefit, for
like
example?
For example, we have people looking at the Facebook whole day. and sometimes they're unnecessary things.
But they may say, "I'm learning a lot of things that I perhaps
might
have not learned before."
Well, there are so many other important things to learn.
Okay.
So we've got people, those who are busy just looking at who did what someone like, you know, did
gossip
something.
And other
gossip
things.
And someone did something like funny, someone did. And I see people are like, you know, going through the whole entire day. And this is a knowledge that doesn't benefit. And this is the reason why we lose our memory today. Why don't we remember? Amader shoron shokti khubi kome geche. কারণ আমরা বিজি সিং থিংস দ্যাট নট ডাজেন্ট বেনিফিট ওকে তারপরে আমাদেরকে আদাব এবং ম্যানারিজম অ্যান্ড ক্যারেক্টার দিতে হবে অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ দ্য রিজন সাম স্কলার্স দে সেড দ্য মিনিং অফ ইসলাম ইজ আদাব দ্য মিনিং অফ ইসলাম ইজ আখলাক মিনিং হোয়াট ইসলাম এইমস টু মেক আ পার্সন অফ ক্যারেক্টার কোড অফ কন্ডাক্ট ম্যানারিজম বিহেভিয়ার উই মে হ্যাভ সো মাচ নলেজ বাট নো বিহেভিয়ার নো ক্যারেক্টার নো বেনিফিট Because Islam aims to give adab to people. And we have so much knowledge today, but the problem, we have arrogance, knowledge, there's so much arrogance, ahankar, gaurab, because amar kache kichu knowledge ache, ami gyani hoye gechi, ahankar, ebong onnodike amader kache roye geche je bhalo byabohar nei. Knowledge ache, bhalo byabohar nei. But meaning of Islam is good behavior, and we have to instill this to our children. Tarpore amader samar holiday chole asche. Samar amader chele meyederke amra engage rakhte hobe. We have to keep them busy. Because otherwise they will go and busy themselves with things that you don't want. মানে আমরা যদি আমাদের ছেলেমেয়েদেরকে এই জিনিসগুলো নিয়ে ব্যস্ত না রাখি যে জিনিসগুলো মানে বেনিফিশিয়াল ফায়দামন্দ তাহলে ওরা কিন্তু খারাপ জিনিসের দিকে চলে যাবে When I say make them busy, meaning keep them busy, engaged.
Now, because you have touched that, summer holiday is coming up and the children will be off from uni or colleges or schools.
Yes, yes.
And because we are seeing knife crime is increasing at a very
exactly,
epidemic
very
level,
alarming,
at a very alarming level.
Serious issue.
এবং এরকম হচ্ছে ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল found out to be at the wrong time, in the wrong place, and ending up becoming a victim.
Exactly.
এখানে আপনার প্যারেন্টসদের কাছে আপনার কি উপদেশ থাকবে?
আমি যে জিনিসটা বলতে চাচ্ছি যে আমাদেরকে আমাদের পিতামাতাদেরকে আরেকটু আমরা সজাগ হতে হবে এবং আমাদেরকে আরেকটু চতুর ক্লেভার হতে হবে। এবং the best way I think is my experience is that when you make children, give them tasks, make them busy, take them to places. Maybe like, you know, send them to like
Engage, educate, anything that makes them busy. We want easy way out. We have work, we all have commitments.
But we cannot do that because our children are our legacy. And we have to find ways to kind of like engage. And as you have mentioned earlier, I know people, those who go out every single evening to where?
What do they do? What benefit does
and
it become
people,
to the society?
I know people, they just go and hang around and gossip and chat.
And they want
and
to And not only that, they want themselves to be mentioned on the television, on the papers, on the social media.
And leave the children with the gadgets. And we don't understand what's happening here. আপনার ঘরে আপনার বাসার মধ্যে কিন্তু আপনার ছেলেমেয়েরা পরিবর্তন হয়ে যাচ্ছে. They don't have to go out. They're being changed here. They're being brainwashed in many ways. And I've been told by somebody today, I mean, I don't watch films, but someone told me that, you know, many of those films even cause the family problems at home, especially a lot of, Asian films, like, you know, cause actually like the family issues, conflict within the household.
For instance, I understand where you're coming from extramarital affairs to all the other aspects that are constantly being promoted
on those kind of aspects. But we are so busy, as even elders, we are so busy in things that are not beneficial.
Now, ikhane arekta jinish mention kora uchit, ma babar ki eta daitto na je jana je amar baccha kothay ache.
Okay, now that's another important point.
We don't know.
Yes, we need to keep a constant guidance, but not, obviously, I don't mean to say monitor all the time.
Spy.
Not spying. Hmm. But we need to give them space and time, because they have also some, obviously, like, as people. But we need to keep...
Freedom of thakte hobe, plus guidance of thakte hobe.
24 ghonta tar upore ami mane durbin lagiye ami dekhchi. Eta kintu thik noy.
Mane extreme na, dui extreme na.
Eta kintu beneficial na. Eta kintu successful hoa jay na. So what we have to do, a general care, a general guidance, a general... আমাদের ছেলেমেয়ে কোথায় আছে? মানে অনেক ছেলেমেয়েরা কিন্তু 12টা 1টা 2টা হয়ে যাচ্ছে বাসার, কিন্তু ফিরে আসতে চায়, স্কুল থেকে কোথায় যাচ্ছে আমরা আমাদের খবর নেই, কিন্তু আমাদের পিতামাতারা গাফিল হয়ে আমরা আছি এবং তারপরে আমরা কান্নাকাটি করি, আর ক্রাইং লেটার অন, ওয়াই? বিকজ উই ডিড নট অ্যাক্ট টেক দ্য রাইট অ্যাকশন দ্য রাইট টাইম.
আরেকটা জিনিস হচ্ছে, আমাদের একটা ফলস বিলিফ আছে যে আমার ছেলে এটা করবে না, আমার মেয়ে এটা করবে না. But we never realize today is someone else, tomorrow could be my children.
Some people have overconfidence and some people have no confidence. Both are wrong. So you have to be, again, like, create moderation. The overconfidence hote parbe na amaderke jante, karon apni janen na children are capable of doing many things. Then when only they do, then you realize apnar shojag hoben.
And then
apnar bashay boshe achen kintu apnar chele hoyto kon Scotland chole geche
na, tokhon ta amra kintu tokhon amra eita boli, amra shun apni hoyto imam apni onek nishchoy shunechen, tokhon amra boli je Allah ami ki dosh korlam je amake ei rokom ekta trial and tribulation dilen.
Tar pore arekta jinish amake eta bolte hobe, amader chele amar onek pitamatara kintu chesta koren.
Okay.
Chesta korar pore jodi eta successful na hoy, tohole eta kintu Allah paker bishoy. Inna ka la tahdi man ahbabta. আমাদের প্রিয় নবী মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম উনিও চেষ্টা করে অনেক লোকদেরকে হেদায়েত দিতে পারেন নাই.
উনি নিজে চাচা
ওনার, জি, এবং উনি অনেক ওনার পার্শ্ববর্তী অনেক লোক ওনাদেরকে উনি হেদায়েতের মালিক আল্লাহ. ওকে, বাট আওয়ার রেসপন্সিবিলিটি ইজ ডুইং অ্যাকশন অ্যান্ড আমাদেরকে করতে হবে,
মানে ট্রাস্ট ইন আল্লাহ বাট টাই ইওর ক্যামেল.
এবং এটা, জি, অবশ্যই. এবং আরেকটা জিনিস আছে, আপনি যদি চেষ্টা করে যান তো এক সময়, এবং দোয়া করতে থাকেন, এক সময় কিন্তু ছেলেমেয়েরা ফিরে আসে,
ইনশাআল্লাহ.
দে কাম ব্যাক, দে কাম ব্যাক. বাট উই হ্যাভ টু ডু রাইট থিং ইন রাইট টাইম, কিপ দেম বিজি, এঙ্গেজ. সামার ইজ কামিং, অ্যান্ড টেক দেম অ্যান্ড টু সামার স্কুলস, লাইক গুড স্কুলস, অ্যান্ড দেন, ইউ নো, টেক দেম ফর আ ড্রাইভ, মেবি সাম টাইম টু দ্য পার্ক, অ্যান্ড মেনি থিংস উই ক্যান ডু. উই ক্যান ফাইন্ড আউট ওয়েজ হাউ উই ক্যান কিপ দেম বিজি উইথ দ্য ফিজিক্যাল থিং অ্যান্ড নট উইথ দ্য গ্যাজেটস অ্যান্ড মিডিয়া অ্যান্ড ইলেকট্রনিক মিডিয়া.
জাযাকাল্লাহ খায়র ফর টুডে. উই উড লাভ টু কন্টিনিউ আর ডিসকাশন, বাট আনফরচুনেটলি দ্য আওয়ার ইজ আপ, ইনশাআল্লাহ. থ্যাংক ইউ very much, and hope to see you inshallah in our next episode. With this, my dear viewers, we have come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion, Our Children, Our Legacy. Especially from the last point that we have discussed, and that is summer holiday nishchoy ashche, and that's the time when we need to ensure that our children are engaged with things that can contribute to their development, to their enhancement, and that can benefit them not only from the worldly perspective but also in the akhirah. And amader daitto hocche jara ma babara achi, we need to know where our children is, and we need to be careful of the area that we live in. We need to ensure who the friends are, who they hang around with. Karon eta jodi na jani, may Allah protect us, jodi erokom kono durghotona ghote, then the only solution is, the best way is, first we need to be precautious, we need to be careful so that our children can be protected, and thus by protecting our children we are protecting our family and the society and the community at large. Inshallah, that's all for tonight. Do look after yourself, and we'll be inshallah back again in the next week discussing a new topic. Until then, subhanakallah wa hamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much.
A pleasure.